What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Minecraft. And, oh boy, do I have a lot of stuff to show you. I have done a lot of work since the last episode. Pretty much 24 hours of work. This is a blacksmith house. It's quite cool, and I've got quite a lot of stuff to show you, so it will probably take most of the episode, and that's why I want to speed things along, so I don't have to spend half the episode showing you stuff that I built off camera. So this is the inside of the blacksmith house. Got white stained panes, doors, really nice. Furnaces, furnace, whatever. A random chest, crafting table, bed, and then this is a really cool thing here. I'm going to explain after a bit. Anvil and the water barrel to cool whatever you're making. And a crafting table looks good for the bottom of a barrel. And here I've got a fire up there, yeah. That makes it look like there's smoke coming out of the chimney, yes, because it's giving off the smoke particles. And it also gives you a nice fire crackle, and it's slightly distant, so it's not like it's too noisy. And it's like the coals are kind of burning. Plus this is animated, so that's really cool. And then here I've got a dispenser with some fire charges. And there's a fire. And then it goes out by itself, so that's really cool. But I'm going to put that out for now. So yeah, that's pretty cool. What am I doing? We've still got the sugarcane farm to harvest over there. I haven't finished building it. I've done nothing since then on the actual farm. I've just done a little bit of work on the building. Up there is a nice farm. I'll show you that in a bit. And over here, I've done a whole bunch of work on the farm, like normal farm. And not here. I still need to do some stuff here. I believe we can harvest all of these. Yep, looks good. And I've put a ceiling now. Walls everywhere. Got nice lamps, although I don't like glowstone. Looks a bit ugly. I think I'll change that to redstone lamps if I decide to do something. This chest here and this chest here is going to, there's going to be pumpkin farm here and a melon farm here. And then there's an also chicken cooker thing here. I haven't finished working on this bit yet. I only got a little bit. And I've got enough levels to enchant two things, and I'm going to enchant two swords. This is really simple. You can find these designs on the internet. Got a little access to the wine room here. Got it all nice and lit up so that there's no lighting updates causing any problems. I'm not going to harvest this right now. I've just been caving, and I also went to the Nether, and in like 10 minutes I got like two stacks, just over two stacks of Nether quartz. So, like 10 minutes, and I didn't even go anywhere really. Oh yeah, I've got a nice jukebox over here, so I'm... is that too loud? I'm not too sure, so I'm just going to turn it down a little bit. This is my favourite song, by the way, in Minecraft. Not the full game, out of the music discs. Most people, like, hear the beginning and they're like, this is disgusting. Just listen to it a bit further on. Got some blaze rods. Try to clean this up as much as possible. I'll show you what's happened to all the enchanted stuff here. Oh yeah, we never put up a beacon. Oh yeah, by the way. And right now, go into the comments page section. And write whether I should or should not replace all the spawners, because they're just pig spawners, they don't even spawn pigs. And that really sucks, all of them. Over here I've got a little area for putting my enchanted things away. This is going to be for swords, this is going to be for axes, picks, shovels, books, and books. Got a lot of books here, and quite a few picks, and I'm just going to enchant these two swords. Disgusting. Even worse. Wow. I was really hoping for something a little bit better than that. As you can see, I've already got a stack of ice. Over here, I've done a little bit more cooking, or a bunch more stuff. I now got 10 stacks of coal, or charcoal, and like 13 stacks. No, way more. I don't remember how many, but a lot of stacks of nether brick. That's for the, that's to work on the nether hub, yeah. Over here I've got a little sign for villager trading, and I've been trading with some of these villagers, and I got a mending book, so yay. And I got a bunch more emeralds. I just copied this book. I get a bunch of books and book and quill with it, and just copy them. Unfortunately, book and quills do not stack, so that kind of sucks. I have to do it manually. Can't just shift click through the whole thing. And the ice farm. Finally. Whilst I'm getting there, I'll just tell you a small story. What happened earlier on today. I was just in the nether, and I was just about to go back home. I had a few ghosts spawn, and I killed them all, yeah? And then I was, like, pretending that I was recording the episode, and I was just saying to myself, oh, yeah, and in the nether hub section, it's big enough for ghosts to spawn, and then I went there, and there was a ghost, and it was about to shoot me, and I shot it fireball back at itself, and nothing got blown up, so that was really lucky. This is a little ice farm, but, of course, this isn't the final way it's going to look like, because this that's basically nothing. This only gives you 48 every harvest. I would like to at least have a lot more than that. I'm about to lose my voice. What else should I do? I remember doing anything else that might be important? Not really. Well, let's go check out the sugarcane that I have grown back there, and then we'll actually start the episode. So, this is the sugarcane farm underground part. There's basically a bunch of chests for storage here. Got lighting there. I don't mind the way glowstone looks with sandstone. Great, it's turning nighttime. There's a bunch of chests here and stuff like that. And let's just sleep real quick. Okay, let's harvest all of this stuff. All you have to do is just run around like this. This is all you have to do to harvest this. This is why I like this game. But of course then you have to do this. And if I'm correct, this will give you about how many stacks I put into this. This will give me about 8 stacks, probably. Maybe a bit more. What I don't like about this is that you have to run around afterwards collecting it every little bit. That's like a really tedious job, because you might miss something. Oh, I was wrong. Apparently I put a lot less than 8 stacks in this. Well, that kind of sucks. But never mind, we'll expand this, like, a lot. This thing is going to go up there like the villager trading thing, and I'm just going to start filling these chests with this stuff. The reason I'm doing a sugarcane farm, one of the reasons is for villager trading, actually. I'm connecting everything together, as you can see. What really is... because, like, I lost my thought. Because I have some good paper trades with villagers, why not use the paper for trading? And besides, paper is like so easy to get. You just need to have a massive sugarcane farm and then you're set, basically. Oh yeah, let's finally decide what we're doing this episode. If possible, I'd like to make a firework workshop. But, of course, this is random, and I will probably do the firework workshop thing off camera if I really want to. But, let's go. Come on. Mega wheat farm, okay. This is going to be a pain. Okay, well, I'll select a spot and all that kind of stuff, and then we'll get to work. Okay, so I know this is kind of like cheating, but I've already done the farming episode like recently, and I don't want to bore you guys, so I'm just going to reselect, and you might notice a difference in my voice. Oh great, I don't have the resources for that. Perfect. Ice farm, no. Give me either this, no actually, don't give me that. Give me this, this, or this, please. That's all I can do this episode, really. I don't have anywhere to make those go to, really, do I? Sorry for kind of like selecting this instead of making it random. Oh great, wow. So the reason my voice is different is because I'm using a different camera right now. Oh, I said camera. A different mic right now. It's integrated into my webcam, not the one that's inbuilt, integrated into my laptop. The one that's integrated into my external webcam, and that has really good sound quality. And sorry if some of this episode sounds like the way it used to, noisy in the background, but I can't actually hear the difference because I can hear my laptop right now, so I won't be able to hear it in the video, so sorry about that. I guess we'll find out. I just wanted to do like a bit of a sound difference in this episode. So we're building a mob system, and great, what block should I use? I want to use some kind of colorful block, but one that's easy enough to get. Definitely not stone, that's just bleh. I guess I can put this back on because you can hear me alright, yay! I actually had my sounds up to full, well, my master volume to full. I still have the sound settings to normal, well, the way I usually have them. Well, first of all, the mob system I've already planned is going to go somewhere around there, but I might change my mind, so I'll just do a bunch of resource gathering and then I'll start working. It had been many years since DoomSkull decided to make a mob system. Oh, but he couldn't pick out a block that he would build it out of. Oh, but then he decided to make it out of dark oak. And oh no, he never came back from the forest. 10 years later, he only collected 3.5 stacks. Just kidding. I've only been here for about 10 minutes. It's about night time now, and I decided to make the mob system out of dark oak, planks of course, otherwise it would be way too expensive for me to pull off that trick. Would probably take me longer to build it than I'll actually be in this world for. Okay, I think I'm good for now. I'll just head back But it did take me like 10 years to work out what kind of block I wanted to use, because there's just not enough and so many at the same time. Like, I wanted one that didn't really have a different texture. Ooh, zombies. Can't sleep. Okay. Oh yeah, check out this, guys. This is so cool. You can do pretty much both at the same time. It's really cool. You have the sword, and you have the sword already charged, ready for it to be used as soon as you fire it. As soon as you fire the sword. And you can actually play like this. I tried it, but it's really uncomfortable. It starts getting really uncomfortable because, like, you eat a food and then the bow starts charging, and then you end up shooting. Yeah, it's really uncomfortable. But that could free up a slot in your hotbar. So, but I won't be doing that in the UHC. Just in case you're wondering, there's going to be another UHC soon. Still building the map. I'm pretty much finished with it, but I made a big mistake. It'll take me maybe 3 more hours to go around that mistake. Just over 5 stacks of wood. I was hoping I would have gotten 10 by that time. Anyway, I'm running a bit low on time, so I'm gonna hurry up here. Okay, so I've got a bit of an area cleared here now, so I think I can start working. The center will probably go about here. This is also an Etho design, not mine, and I've been using it for a long, long time now. I really like this design. It's really helpful, and if I remember, then I will put a link in the description to Etho's episodes where he does this. I run a little bit low on space, but I'll have to move this. Damn it. But you get the idea of this. I might do a little bit of a speed kind of thingy right now, but probably not actually. There's something else I want to talk about too. Okay, well, if I have it like this, yeah, I can just block that off. Okay. By the way, guys, I already have an idea for my 1 million sub special. If I get there in about 5 years time, then I'll be like perfect. You'll know why when you see it, probably. I'm not going to give you all the details right now, but it's going to be a massive free run, about 4.5 minutes, and I already chose my music. And well, the reason I chose the music now is actually because I like the music, and that gave me an idea to do the free run thing for a special. And it'll be like really cool, but it will require me to be at least 18, I think. I'm not sure what it is in the UK. But it should be really awesome, hopefully. And I didn't really need to destroy these two, did I? Waste of time. No, I don't even do this. I'm sure you have seen this design already, so I'm not going to show this to you. and I'm just going to build a few layers now, and I will get back to you in just a second. Okay, so I have used up all my resources for this. That's 5 stacks of wood logs, so that is about 10 stacks of blocks for every layer of this. So this is a very expensive project indeed, and I'll just show you what's inside this. Got some lamps there to not let any mobs spawn right now. I've got these half slabs here so that spiders don't spawn, because they need a 3x3 area, and that stops them from spawning, and it just basically doesn't let the mob system to clog up, because the spiders can climb, and it's going to lower the rates of mob spawning and stuff like that. And basically there's going to be 12 layers of this. Got 2 done, well, 2.5 kind of, the roof counts as half I guess. So that's 10 stacks of blocks plus more, like the water blocks and the half slabs and other lamps and stuff like that. So do not attempt to do this one, it will take you ages. Yeah, I can get out of here, good. But I got a bunch of TNT ready, so we'll just go and blow up that mountain, and then it's the end of the episode, I'm afraid. Used up a lot of the time today thinking, didn't we? Oh yeah, over here I cleared a bunch of trees. I think I could like put some kind of watchtower here, and like have it go quite tall actually, and have like a fire thing there, so that, like, although it won't really be seen if I build that. Never mind. So I'll just go lay the charges and then we'll end it. Okay, so let's see how this works out. Loud. That was actually pretty cool. So thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.